This is an umbrella. I use it a lot on rainy days. Of course, at some point, it doesn't work anymore. Well, it might be easier for me to get a new one because there are so many options out there and the accessibility to get one easily. Besides, it's not too expensive. So wait, if everyone on the planet does the same as I do, how many umbrellas are going to end up in the landfill? And this is not just talking about umbrellas, but we are talking about broken furnitures, luggage bags, or even watches that are not functional anymore, but actually you just need to replace a battery, and all the broken stuff that we are mentioned about. Yes, it's tons of resources to make this stuff. We make stuff, we use stuff, we throw stuff. What if we replace these small actions to fix this throwaway culture? We can eventually fix this little guy and use it again.
Umbrella Station 这个大概是2009年创办的，到现在大概有11年左右了。当初的时候只是想着只是卖好伞啊，然后维修伞没有试过，就抱着试一试的心态啦。然后呢，维修过后了之后，就有顾客觉得不错，就介绍朋友啊，或者是邻居什么给我们修雨伞，什么问题的雨伞，大致上80%都可以维修，包括它换伞布啊、断骨啊、破洞漏水啊、handle 破啊，或者是还有开关不能啊，那些问题都可以了，变成更加环保了，不用浪费。很多人他们拿来修的时候，都会给我看一下。我会帮他们看值不值得修，如果是太薄的雨伞，我是不建议顾客修的，因为修了也用不久。我会帮他们修那些他们可以用很久的雨伞，更耐用。我也本身也是建议他们要买就买好的雨伞，因为耐用的雨伞修了会用更久。每次做雨伞的时候，我们为什么要浪费30分钟到一个小时，就是我们全部要做到安全，不能急的修雨伞呢。越急的话越容易修错，修错一个部位的话要重新全部拆了再修多一次，变成要2个小时。所以修雨伞看起来简单，实际上很难。这样然后再接回去了。很多方法都是没有人教的，都是自己啊想办法跟客人改造啊，因为真的工厂是不会教这些东西，因为老实说如果教了的话，他们的雨伞就卖不出了，全部都拿来维修，所以呢私底下都是自己学的。我们现在这个是环保价钱6块到9块了，所以我们本身是赚不多。如果要维持这个行业，就是说希望大家尽量拿多点雨伞来维修了，除了环保也可以省钱了。要修雨伞的话呢，在我们的 Facebook Umbrella Station 那个 page 那边找到我们。
In fact, they are not trash, they are our belongings. Let's learn to give values to our stuff. Well, we hope you enjoyed this episode of Fix the System. Do not know where to find places to repair? We got you covered on Zero Waste Malaysia map that fall under repair categories, or you can learn to fix your stuff. If you find any more repair shop or interesting shops that falls under Zero Waste Malaysia map, do let us know so we can include them on the map to benefit the community to live zero waste. Done. See you next time. Jumpa lagi.